Hello and welcome to Very Hard Questions, the quiz contest that unsurprisingly asks the very hardest questions on television. I often ask myself very hard questions, like, why do we write things down but type things up? We've assembled some of the brightest brains in Britain to do battle in the very hardest of quizzing competitions. The more points our teams can score, the greater their chances of winning a place in the grand final, where the victors will walk away with a £5,000 prize, this magnificent trophy, and the crown of Very Hard Questions Series champion. Playing today are Owen, Gareth and Sue, also known as the Desperate Daniels, and up against them are Morven, Mickey and Keith. They are the leading lights. We tossed a coin backstage and Desperate Daniels, you're going to go first. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Just tell me a little bit about you. Why are you Desperate Daniels?
We are the family Daniel, or at least three quarters of the family Daniel. Right. My wife, Sue, my eldest son, Owen. And hopefully, we are desperate in wanting to win the trophy, but not desperate in not being able to answer the questions.
OK, now, I hear you are a very formidable quizzing trio on the North Cardiff circuit.
Well, we do regular pub quizzes.
I go as well.
But there's also a monthly quiz we do. The questions in that are slightly harder than in, like, a normal pub quiz, so we find it a challenge and we regularly attend that, don't we?
Now it's time to meet today's challengers. Welcome to the show, the leading lights. Are you all very, very bright?
No, it's incandescent.
It's a theatrical connection, John.
Ah, and what is that?
Well, we're all members of a very good little theatre in Surrey called the Miller Centre in Caterham.
And Morven, you're a long way south from where you come from.
Yes, I was born in Glasgow.
I know that you like the Morven Peninsula, but they don't spell it right.
No, they add an R, Morvern.
Very good, very good. Keith, you design costumes for the theatre?
Set and costumes for theatre, yes. I'm sort of semi-retired now, so I've taken a slight back step because I was teaching at Central School of Speech and Drama for about 13 years.
Good, good. Well, it's great to meet you and good luck today. Let's play Very Hard Questions. In round one, each team will answer four very hard questions. But to help, you have seven clues to use across the round. First letter gives you the first letter of the first word of the answer. Picture clue offers up a visual cryptic clue. Extra fact gives you more information about the answer. Definition is a dictionary-style description of the answer. Add words inserts more information into the question itself. Different question shows you another question with the same answer. And related words, which are three words, all connected to the answer. The clues will help you narrow down the answer. But every time a clue is used, it will cost you a point and you won't be able to use it again in the round. So do use them wisely and make sure you don't end up completely clueless. Desperate Daniels, let's have a look at your first very hard question. The image of a bear eating from a strawberry tree appears in the emblem of which city and was added to a local football club's badge in 1917?
Right.
What do you reckon?
Okay,
do you want to choose?
A city that has a bear as its emblem is Boone.
Boone, I was going to say.
Oh, that's okay, because I don't know anything particular to begin with.
Boone's bears,
and I'm sure that it's actually a bear standing on,
it's on the side.
Hind legs.
Because I was thinking maybe like a German football club.
This is worth 4 points.
But maybe we need
to take... I definitely
think
we need a clue. Yeah.
We need a clue.
Yeah, just to make sense. So,
but each time you use a clue, you lose a point. You've got 4 points.
Add in a word.
Right, should we add a word?
So I think add in a word, yeah.
Could we add a word, please?
Right, add words. The image of a bear eating from a strawberry tree appears in the emblem of which European city and was added to a local football club's badge in 1917.
The thing is, it doesn't really narrow it down, but wow.
The bear is the emblem of Burn, though.
But they're asking for the city, not the football
no,
team.
No, I know,
so
yeah, yeah.
The
first letter would give it straight away, presumably, or at least rule out some.
Yeah, should we go for that?
Could we have the first letter, please?
First letter, M.
Oh, right. That's different.
It's not Bayern Munich, is it?
But then it's Bayern Munich.
Oh, yeah.
This is now worth 2 points.
Oh, but it's a city.
Oh, yeah, so
it's
we just go for that then?
It's not the football.
It's got to be Munich.
Go for Munich then, OK. Munich.
I think our answer will be Munich.
For 2 points, let's see if Munich is the correct answer. Incorrect. The correct answer is Madrid.
Madrid.
Oh. The emblem appears on the badge of Atletico Madrid Football Club. The leading lights, here is your first very hard question. According to Oxford Dictionaries, the name of what colour, derived from modern Latin, honours a botanist who lived from 1501 to 1566?
Botanist.
So it's a colour that's probably got something to do with a flower, maybe?
Lapis. I would think it would be a flower, wouldn't
this
it?
This is worth 4 points. Can you answer for 4 points, or are you going to have to use
a clue? I think we're going to have to use a clue.
A related word? Let's try a related word. Yes, I think so. Yes.
OK, related words. Leonard, magenta, genii.
Magenta's a form of red.
Red, it is a colour, isn't it? Yeah, so it's obviously but not...
We're not going to get it at the moment, are we?
No, we're not. No. I don't think so.
Different question.
May we have a different question, please?
Different question. Played by Niamh McIntosh in a BBC adaptation, Titus Groan's sister in the Gormenghast novels by Mervyn Peake has what first name?
I saw this. I saw these. Oh. Is it something with a V, a green, colour of a green?
Viridian.
Viridian was a clue, wasn't
Viridian or...
Vermilion?
No, that doesn't
It's not vermilion.
Vermilion.
Vermilion's
would be better
a red.
Because it's a red.
Yeah.
Oh, what are we going to go
let's
for?
Let's go for try.
We're going to try vermilion, then.
For 2 points, let's see if vermilion is the correct answer.
No.
Sadly, it's incorrect. Well, these are very hard questions, and they've proved it this round. The botanist was Leonard Fuchs.
Fuchsia, of course.
Fuchsia.
Fuchsia.
Fuchsia. Well done.
Fuchsia red.
A very good retrospective answer.
Absolutely.
But alas, no points. Let's have a look back at related words. Leonard. Leonard Fuchs is the name of the German botanist the name of the colour is derived from. Magenta. The dye fuchsine was renamed magenta after the Battle of Magenta. Genii. Genii is the name of a common variety of fuchsia plant.
Yes.
Well, Desperate Daniels, let's have a look at your second very hard question. Angie Dickinson and Henry Silver both appeared in which film, as well as making brief cameos in its remake?
I'm trying to think of modern westerns that are remakes of old films. They remade True Grit recently, but I didn't know.
That was John Wayne.
No,
that was...
Neither of them were in that, I don't think.
They made a remake of The Magnificent Seven, haven't they?
Have they? I'm not sure.
Not aware.
I'm sure they have.
I think we're going to need to use a clue.
4 points up for grabs.
We're going to need to use a clue.
Right, let's go out for extra fact, is it? Could we have extra
fact,
please?
Coming up. The film is about a group of ex-paratroopers who plot to commit a crime.
Right.
It's not a western.
Completely different,
yeah. Film, then.
Yeah.
I really haven't got a clue at all.
We need some points, don't we?
We'll cost you another point, but you've got 3 points in play at the moment.
Should we try related
words?
Yeah,
related words.
Related words, please.
Related words. Rat, Danny, Sahara.
I'm not sure what all their nicknames are, but in the Oceans films, Danny Ocean is the main character.
Oh, yeah, that's true, yeah.
And I don't know those two actors in that, but that's been remade. Ocean's 11, because they made sequels, but Ocean's 11 is the only original
one. Original.
Yeah, Ocean's 11 is the only one.
Should we go for that?
I think it's the only thing we can think of.
Go for that?
Ocean's 11?
Go on.
Yeah.
We need some
points. We're going to go for Ocean's 11.
For 2 points, let's see if Ocean's 11 is the correct answer. Yes, Ocean's 11. Right, congratulations.
Well done.
The related words were Rat, Danny and Sahara. Rat, the Rat Pack star in the film. Danny, the title character's first name is Danny Ocean, as you said. Sahara, one of the casinos targeted in the film, is called the Sahara. Congratulations, you're off the mark.
You've
got 2 points.
Thank you.
The leading lights, let's have a look at your second very hard question. The winner of the Best Actor Tony for a performance in which play had their statuette engraved with an inscription honouring retired builder Mickey Ley, who had inspired their central role.
Now, this sounds to me we could be in Arthur Miller territory here.
I was thinking...
You were thinking Arthur Miller territory?
View from the Brit.
Which one has... it's not All My Sons, is it? It's not... Is it?
No, he wasn't a builder.
He wasn't a builder.
He made an airplane.
Mickey Ley.
Worth 4 points at the moment, if we go for it.
If we go first letter, we might get A or something
That's
like that.
That's true, actually.
Do you feel you can answer for 4 points, or do you need a clue?
Should we try a first letter?
Yeah.
May we try an additional clue, a first letter, please, John?
First letter. J.
It's not Jerusalem, is it? That's that play.
Well, it could be.
It's a play, Jerusalem, with Mark. Do you remember Mark Rylance?
Yeah.
That's the only. There aren't many plays that begin with J that I can think of.
But it might be, though, because he's that sort of character.
He's a character. Have you seen it?
Yeah.
Been to see it?
I hated it. He did win Best Actor for Tony.
Tony.
Oh, in that case,
only
I think...
only one I can think of.
Should we take a punt?
Yep,
I think
we think it might be Jerusalem.
For 3 points, let's see if Jerusalem is the correct answer. Well done.
Yes.
Congratulations.
Well done.
In the play Jerusalem, the character Rooster is based on Mickey Lay, a retired builder from Wiltshire. Mark Rylance won a Tony Award for playing this role. Very, very impressive. You've scored 3 points. We are at the halfway point of round one, so let's take a look at the scores. Desperate Daniels have 2 points and the Leading Lights have 3 points. Can either of our teams pull away when they face some more very hard questions after the break? Welcome back to Very Hard Questions, where our teams are vying for a top two spot on the leaderboard and a place in the end of series final. Desperate Daniels, let's have a look at your next very hard question. Reported to be worth over £1 million, the swallow tattoos on Kate Moss's lower back were designed and etched by which artist?
It's not going to be a tattoo artist, is it? It's going to be an artist who's designed it and then a tattooist has done it.
Can we think
of an artist that you'd link with a swallow?
Yeah.
Or is that just something Kate Moss wanted?
Take a clue.
We've got to have a clue.
Yeah, we've got to have a clue.
Yeah.
Worth 4 points at the moment if we go for it, but otherwise it's 3 points.
Different question.
Different question, I think.
Could we have a different question?
A different question. Who painted Benefits Supervisor Sleeping that was, according to auction house Christie's, the most expensive painting ever sold at auction by a living artist when it was sold in 2008?
I've heard of Benefits Supervisor Sleeping.
But it sounds like Damien Hirst or...
But she was just not a graffiti artist. That's the sort of title of a Banksy piece of graffiti, isn't it?
3 points in play. You just have 2 clues left in this round.
I just think Benefits Supervisor Sleeping sounds Banksy.
Yeah, do you want to go for that?
Go on, then.
Right, we're going to go for Banksy.
For 3 points. Let's see if Banksy is the correct answer. Oh, dear, it was a brave one. The correct answer is Lucian Freud. He used to design tattoos for his colleagues while serving in the Merchant Navy. The Leading Lights, let's have a look at your third very hard question. In the men's game, which cricketer became the first England bowler to take 2 test match hat-tricks where 3 wickets are taken with 3 successive balls?
The only person I think might possibly be, I would say, is possibly Ian Botham.
Botham or somebody like Freddie Truman, who was a demon
bowler.
It's worth 4 points and you've got 4 clues to play with.
Because we've got those 4 left, so let's see whether... Let's try a picture clue, shall we?
Yeah, we'll try a picture clue.
Right, picture clue.
Oh, it's Broads.
Stuart Broad.
Stuart Broad.
You reckon?
Yeah, I think so, because it's the Broads, isn't it? Mm. Sure. Yeah,
are we going to go
worth 3 points.
Yeah,
we're going to punt on Stuart Broad.
For 3 points, let's see if Stuart Broad is the correct answer. Stuart Broad it is. Yep.
Yes.
Broad's first hat-trick was against India in 2011. He repeated the feat against Sri Lanka in 2014. And this was indeed a picture of the Norfolk Broads.
Yes.
3 points there for the Leading Lights. Desperate Daniels, let's have a look at your final very hard question of the round. The Comedy Playhouse episode titled Of Funerals and Fish was a pilot for which television programme?
Terribly certain about it.
I mean,
it.
The Comedy Playhouse. Do you know even where that's based?
Well, that used to be Playhouse used to be in the 60s and 70s, and they'd put out a play and see what the reaction was to it, and then maybe develop a...
How long did it go on for? Because thinking of a date for a comedy...
Well, we
might as well use a clue.
But each time you use a clue, you lose a point. You've got 4 points at the moment.
I know.
Yeah.
I reckon use the picture clue.
Have a picture clue.
Yeah, we'll go for the picture clue.
Let's have a look at the picture clue.
Right.
Oh, it's Last of the Summer Wine.
It is.
That's Combo's hat.
I'm happy to go for that.
Yeah, I think we'll go for Last of the Summer Wine.
For 3 points, let's see if Last of the Summer Wine is the correct answer. Yeah. Well done. Well done indeed. That scores you 3 points. Very well done. The leading lights, let's have a look at your final very hard question of the round. Harvested from around the roots of the tequila or mezcal plants, escamoles is a dish made from the edible larvae and pupae of which insect?
Have you got any ideas?
Nothing really.
It's obviously Mexican.
I think we ought to maybe try another.
Yeah, I think so.
Three clues available for this last question.
It's got to be something like an insect with a butterfly or moth.
Oh, that's what I'm thinking. Yeah.
And pupa, isn't it?
Yes.
So it's got to be.
So it's got to be something that goes through that metamorphic.
That's a metamorphosis. Thing. Yeah.
Yeah. Should we maybe take a risk on another clue?
Yeah. I wonder about
extra
definition.
Definition.
Okay. Yeah.
Definition. May we have another clue in a definition, please?
Definition. A member of the Formicidae family of insects with species including leafcutter and bullet.
It is, it's definitely ant.
Yeah.
Our answer is ant.
For 3 points, let's see if ant is the correct answer. Well done.
It's the Formicida, it's the Latin, you see. The formic acid.
Formic acid. Marvellous. Many congratulations, and you have 3 points for it. Well done.
Thank you.
We are at the end of round one, so let's take a look at the scores. Desperate Daniels have 5 points, and the leading lights are leading with 9 points. Can Desperate Daniels catch them in round two? Stay right here to find out. Welcome back to Very Hard Questions, where our teams have been locked in a battle of high-class quizzing. Let's get straight on with round two. Now, in this round, you will tackle your own board of three questions. But be warned, answer a question incorrectly and your round is instantly over and any points scored in the round will be lost. You now only have 5 clues to use across all 3 questions. And remember, the more clues you use, the more points you lose. Let's have a look at your clues. Different question and extra fact, both of which you have already seen. Multiple choice, you'll see 4 possible answer options, but only 1 is correct. Audio clue, you'll be played an oral hint to the answer. Redacted text, you'll see a sentence containing the answer, but the key information has been censored. Desperate Daniels, here's your board of 3 questions. Question 1. In May 2013, who dressed as a flight attendant and served drinks on an Air Asia flight from Perth to Kuala Lumpur after losing a bet with Tony Fernandez? Question 2. What is the common name for the everyday object patented by Walter Hunt in the US on the 10th of April, 1849, apparently to pay off a $15 debt? Question 3. In his 1991 autobiography, Auberon Waugh wrote that his father, Evelyn Waugh, had sunk in his estimation after he ate 3 of which foodstuff intended for his children in front of them?
Right.
Right.
Would you like to tackle first?
Do you think that maybe number 1 might be an easier one to tackle?
Mm. Yeah, I reckon.
Yeah.
I don't know who Walter Hunt is.
No, I think number 1 is more recent. We'll start with question 1, please.
Right. In May 2013, who dressed as a flight attendant and served drinks on an Air Asia flight from Perth to Kuala Lumpur after losing a bet with Tony Fernandez?
Mm. Right. I don't know. There's something that rings a bell about Richard Branson with me. I'm not sure why.
All right.
Don't
worry about that.
Yeah, because I don't know if it's a man or a woman, obviously.
No.
There's no inkling to that.
Well, no. It could be either, couldn't it? But I think we're going to need to
What do you think would be the most useful, though?
OK.
This is worth 4 points.
A
fact. Extra fact.
Extra fact.
Yeah. Could we have an extra fact, please?
Extra fact coming up. Yeah. This person bought an island in the 1970s.
That's Necker Island.
Richard Branson.
I agree with Richard Branson.
Yeah, we'd like to give an answer, and our answer would be Richard Branson.
I need to remind you that if you answer wrongly, then I'm afraid the round is over and you get no points. But let's see, for 3 points, if Richard Branson is the correct answer. Well done indeed.
Yep.
Branson and Tony Fernandez, the owner of AirAsia, had a bet on whose racing team would finish first in the 2010 Formula One Grand Prix in Abu Dhabi, and the loser having to serve as cabin crew on the other one's airline. Oh, there we are. Oh, my God.
The lips. Excellent.
You have 3 points for it. Which question would you like to tackle next?
Yeah. I think we'll go for question two next, please.
What is the common name for the everyday object patented by Walter Hunt in the US on the 10th of April, 1849, apparently to pay off a $15 debt?
There is no way we're going to get it without an extra clue. Is there? So it's just what extra clue?
Multiple choice.
It's the redacted text.
It's worth 4 points and you've got four clues to play with.
Yeah, should we go for the audio?
Yeah, it might be the sound of whatever.
Because I don't think that would help us on the other question.
Yeah, we'll try audio clue.
Audio clue coming up. We can go if we want to.
Night is young and so am I. And we can dress real neat from our hearts to our feet. Probably the name of that song is the name of the object.
Or it could be the name of the artist who's singing it, couldn't it? Just trying to think.
And remember, we don't have to answer it because we don't want to risk it.
That is true. We can't afford
to go on to the other. Mm. Can't afford to lose points.
You weren't sure. Yeah. Okay.
Should we risk losing one more clue?
Well, I think we should.
Keep two for the last
two
one.
Two is better than nothing.
Yeah.
Isn't
but which do you think will be the most useful?
It'll cost you another point.
Yeah. I think we have to sacrifice another point.
What about the redacted text, though?
Should we try that? Redacted text? Can we go for redacted text?
Redacted text. For me, the blank is about rebellion, and I'm punk in the soul. Donatella Versace.
I don't think we can risk it.
I don't think we can risk it.
If you get this incorrect, you'll lose the 3 points in this round.
Yeah.
What would Donatella Versace say?
For me, there's something that's about rebellion.
Should we leave this
about
one?
Everyday objects.
I think we'll have to leave this one.
Yeah, I think we'll leave that question and not answer it.
So if you pass, you can't come back to it, OK? No,
I think that's fine.
Right?
Yeah.
Safety pin is the correct answer.
Oh, what?
Walter Hunt, a prolific inventor, owed the debt to one of the draftsmen he tasked with drawing up his numerous patents. That song you heard there, and we were all mystified by it, The Safety Dance by Men Without Hats.
Oh, really?
I confess I haven't heard of either.
I haven't heard of that.
You heard of Men Without Hats, but not The Safety Dance.
Right. OK. I'm afraid you didn't score any points on that question. Well, let's take a look at your final question. In his 1991 autobiography, Oberon Waugh wrote that his father, Evelyn Waugh, had sunk in his estimation after he ate three of which foodstuff intended for his children in front of them?
What of foodstuff? Is it a specific...
what would children particularly like to eat?
Yeah.
That's their favourite
thing. What would the wars be given to eat? We're not going to get it without
at least one clue.
So do we go different?
Because we don't really know.
It's currently worth 4 points.
Different question?
Yeah.
I think we'll try different question.
Different question. Which fruit appears on the front cover of a 1967 album that sold poorly initially, but was inducted into the US National Recording Registry in 2006?
Right, I think I know what this is.
Is it like a Rolling Stone?
This is a banana, and it was on the Velvet Underground's album.
Answer correctly, and you get 3 points. Answer wrongly, you lose everything you got on this round.
Okay.
Well, what do you think?
I think answer.
Yeah. Answer?
Go on.
Yeah, answer.
Be happy with banana.
Right.
Take a chance,
We're going to answer.
What is your answer?
Take a big risk. Banana.
OK, for 3 points, let's see if banana is the correct answer. Yes. Banana. Yes. Well done. Yeah. Evelyn Waugh took the three bananas, the first they had had since the end of World War II, and ate all of them with cream and sugar. The album was The Velvet Underground and Nico. Desperate Daniels, you scored 6 points out of a possible 12. Leading lights. Here is your board of three questions. Question one. Who curated the Smile High Club exhibition that opened in Lisbon in June 2019, the centrepiece of which was a large collection of ephemera belonging to him? The second question, the direction of flow of which major river was temporarily reversed in 1812 by earthquake tremors and again in 2012 when Hurricane Isaac caused nearly 5,200 cubic metres of water per second to flow upstream? And question three, in 2017, it was announced that which award would be made from recycled yoghurt pots produced in a solar-powered factory?
This is ringing a vague bell with me. Number three.
Which question would you like to tackle first?
Do you want to do number three first, then?
Let's try number three first. Number three, I think.
In 2017, it was announced that which award would be made from recycled yoghurt pots produced in a solar-powered factory?
I think this is something to do with the Olympic medals for the Tokyo Olympics. Something in the back of my head.
This is worth 4 points.
I think we should have a clue.
I think maybe we should have another clue. Redacted text, because if it's Olympic medals.
Yeah, I think redacted text.
Redacted text. May we have a redacted text clue, please?
Redacted text coming up. This is my first blank, and I've always secretly, privately wanted one. Steven Spielberg.
So we might be talking Oscars.
Oscars or BAFTAs or...
No.
This is worth 3 points.
Mm. Yeah, Spielberg. I'm worried about Oscars because Oscars have got a real weight to them.
Yeah.
I think if it's made from recycled yoghurt pots, it's not going to have that much weight involved.
Just to remind you, if you answer incorrectly, your round will be over and no points.
Let's try multiple choice.
Multiple choice. Brit Award, Blue Peter Badge, Commonwealth Games Medal, Duke of Edinburgh's Award.
On that, I think it would be Blue Peter.
Well, but then would... Oh, Stephen, I suppose it would be Stephen Spielberg.
Stephen Spielberg could get one, could he?
I don't think it's Commonwealth Games or the Duke of Edinburgh.
Nor Duke of Edinburgh,
You have one more clue on this question if you want it, but it will cost you.
My initial feeling was wrong. We're now at a situation where we're not really sure either way. I think we're going to have to pass on this one.
Right, then we will pass. The correct answer is Blue Peter Badge.
Oh, it was. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Yep. The green badge was the first to be made from recycled material, with other badges going on to be produced in the same way. Bad luck, no points scored there, but you still have two questions to answer. Which one are you going to tackle?
Number two now, please.
Number two, the direction of flow of which major river was temporarily reversed in 1812 by earthquake tremors and again in 2012 when Hurricane Isaac caused nearly 5,200 cubic metres of water per second to flow upstream.
So Hurricane Isaac hit the Caribbean and the east coast of America, from what I can remember,
so what,
2012. So we're talking about an American river or a South American river. Shall we have a different question? May we have a different question, please?
Different question coming up. Developed in 1938, the Great River Road primarily follows the course of which river?
Isn't that one that somebody drove recently?
It's not the Mississippi, is it? I was thinking the Mississippi as well.
Could it be the Mississippi?
Because the Great River Road seems to make it feel like...
Sounds like America. Doesn't sound like South America. It's more like North America.
Yeah, it does sound more like North America. I think we're still unsure. What about getting an audio clue? Because I'm just thinking it might be a song with Mississippi in it.
Yeah, can we have an audio clue, please?
Right, audio clue coming up.
Mississippi, definitely.
As soon as the audio came up, I thought it would be this. Right.
Courage of convictions, you know.
We have our answer. It's the Mississippi.
Let's see if Mississippi is the correct answer for 2 points. But if you're wrong, the round is over. Mississippi it is. Yeah. Well done. Congratulations. The song you heard was Mississippi by Pussycat, which reached number one in 1976.
Okay, great.
And it scores you 2 points. Here's your final question. Who curated the Smile High Club exhibition that opened in Lisbon in June 2019, the centrepiece of which was a large collection of ephemera belonging to him.
Right, now, I think significant fact is Lisbon. Lisbon. Is it?
Is that the one that then moved to Croydon?
Oh, yeah. But why should it open in Lisbon?
I don't know.
Should we maybe take a risk on another clue?
Yeah.
So would you like to use your final clue?
I think we would, yes, please.
Extra fact coming up. This artist had their first UK number one single in 1999 with a video directed by Spike Jonze.
It must be a pop singer or pop artist of some description.
You're in a sort of dicey situation.
We have no more clues,
and if you get the thing wrong, you've lost.
I think we pass on it.
I don't think we want to risk.
No.
We're going to kick ourselves when you tell us, but
yeah.
You want to pass?
We want to pass.
Okay. I can tell you the correct answer is Fatboy Slim. The exhibition featured a collection of rave culture smiley artifacts. You scored 2 points out of a possible 12.
Oh, dear.
That's the end of round two, so let's see what that's done to the scores. It's all square. Desperate Daniels have 11 points, and the Leading Lights also have 11 points. There's nothing between our teams as we head into round three, when they will face more very hard questions, but this time against the clock. See how they do after the break. Welcome back to Very Hard Questions, where our teams are competing for the points they need to secure a top two spot on the leaderboard. In round three, each team will face five very hard questions, but now every one of them will be against the clock. Give a wrong answer or run out of time, and you score nothing at all. Let's play round three. Desperate Daniels, here's your first very hard question against the clock. Which American actor was born Karen Johnson?
I haven't heard of that original name, but is there another famous actor Karen with Johnson as the surname, perhaps? I think we've got to use a clue.
Clue quick.
Can we add word, please?
Add words. Which EGOT-winning American actor was born Karen Johnson?
No, it doesn't help. No. Maybe a picture clue?
Yeah,
help last time.
Picture clue, please.
Picture clue.
Sister act. That could be Whoopi Goldberg. Do you want to go for that?
Yeah, OK.
Do you have an answer?
We think it's Whoopi Goldberg.
For 2 points, is Whoopi Goldberg the correct answer? Well done, Whoopi Goldberg, it is. The EGOT is when an individual has won an Emmy, Grammy, Oscar and Tony Award. You've scored 2 points. The Leading Lights, here's your first very hard question against the clock. Often regarded as the shortest war, on 27th of August 1896, an armed conflict that lasted around 40 minutes occurred between British forces and which island?
Picture clue.
Picture clue, please.
Picture clue coming up.
Freddie Mercury.
Queen.
Mercury.
Queens. Queensland. Queens.
Or which island?
Different question, please.
Different question. Michael Morpurgo won the 1995 Whitbread Children's Book Award with a novel titled The Wreck of the...
Hispaniola.
Hispaniola. Hispaniola.
For 2 points, is Hispaniola the correct answer?
No.
Oh, dear.
No.
Oh, well. The correct answer is Zanzibar.
That's where he was born.
Yeah.
The war came about when a pro-British sultan died and was replaced by a new leader who hadn't sought the approval of the consul, which was a condition of an earlier treaty. And as you correctly observed, Morven, Freddie Mercury was born in Zanzibar. Desperate Daniels, here's your second very hard question against the clock. Five-time ladies' singles Wimbledon champion Lottie Dodd won an Olympic silver medal in which other sport?
I don't know.
No, Lottie Dodd, I don't know.
Extra fact?
Yeah.
Can we have extra fact, please?
Extra fact. At the 2012 Olympic Games, Lord's Cricket Ground was used as the venue for this sport.
We think that's archery.
Let us see whether archery for 3 points is correct. Archery it is. Congratulations. Very good. Well done. She won her Olympic medal in archery in 1908. Her older brother won gold in archery in the same year. And it scored you 3 points. The Leading Lights, here's your second very hard question against the clock. Who was the inspiration for the character of Ida Bell Tompkins, who is Joel's neighbour in the novel Other Voices, Other Rooms?
Different question?
Different question, yeah.
May we have a different question, please?
Different question coming up. What is the name of the person Sandra Bullock plays in the 2006 film Infamous?
I know the film.
Definition?
Think of a name.
May we have a definition?
Definition coming up. Author, born in 1926 in Monroeville, Alabama.
Picture clue.
Oh, no,
time out. I'm so sorry. I can reveal the answer was Harper Lee.
Really?
I was just going to say Finch. Mm.
The novel is by Truman Capote, who was childhood friends with Harper Lee. Desperate Daniels, here's your third very hard question. A heated metal disc that is placed over a dish such as a crème brûlée to brown the top shares its name with which animal?
Oh, God. I don't know. Should we use...
First letter, please.
First letter coming up. S.
Crumbs.
Sorry.
I don't know. Should we use another one?
Yeah. OK.
Definition?
No, different question, please.
Different question coming up. In his work Natural History, Pliny the Elder suggested that which amphibian was so cold it could even extinguish fire?
Is it called a salamander?
Oh, yeah.
A salamander.
For 2 points, is salamander the correct answer? Wow, you are on form. You've come good, my goodness me. The word is taken from the mythical salamander, which is able to withstand heat. Clever, once you know. You've scored 2 points. The Leading Lights, here's your third very hard question against the clock. As cited in the Oxford English Dictionary, the name of which character was used by The New Scientist in 1988 to describe a planet with suitable conditions for supporting life?
Goldilocks.
You're
going to
go
with
it?
Yeah.
Goldilocks. Let us see for 4 points if Goldilocks is the correct answer. Excellent.
Well done, Morgan.
That's a 4-pointer at a critical moment. It's a Goldilocks planet because it's not too hot and not too cold, but just right.
Just right.
You score 4 points. Desperate Daniels, here's your fourth very hard question against the clock. Surviving portions of a colossal statue of which 4th-century Roman emperor are located in a courtyard of the Palazzo dei Conservatori in Rome?
First letter?
C.
Claudius, perhaps? Constantine. Yeah. Could be one of those two, so maybe go for...
Different question?
Yeah.
Different question coming up. Which 2005 film adaptation of a comic book series stars Keanu Reeves as an occult investigator and exorcist?
Constantine.
For 2 points, is Constantine the correct answer? Constantine, there it is. Well done. Well done. The seated statue would originally have been over 12 metres tall. The head is 2.5 metres in height and each foot is 2 metres long. And it scored you 2 more points. The Leading Lights, here's your fourth very hard question against the clock. In 1934, New Jersey machinist Henry Rushman invented a method of producing which substance?
Different question.
Maybe we have a different question, please.
Different question coming up. In 2001, Mariah Carey released a film and accompanying soundtrack album with what title?
Machinist nylon. First letter. Please.
First letter coming up. G.
Can we have an extra fact, please?
Extra fact coming up. The name of this substance is derived from an old Norse word meaning brightness or to shine.
Gold. No.
Gilt.
The correct answer is, I'm afraid, Glitter.
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 Mariah Carey's film Glitter has a rating of only 7% on the Rotten Tomatoes website. Doesn't get much worse than that. So perhaps it does. Desperate Daniels, here's your final very hard question against the clock. According to the Oxford Dictionary of Literary Terms, what term is a structural device in poetry by which a line or stanza is repeated either identically or with little variation so as to enclose between its two appearances the rest of the poem?
What is in English? What do they use?
Redacted text.
Redacted text coming up. My instructions were I open the blank and then I give it to Faye and she then says what it says. Warren Beatty.
I'm not sure.
Related words.
Related words coming up. Curve, push, Manila.
Envelope.
Yes. Should we? Manila envelope. Should we go for it?
Envelope.
For 2 points, is envelope the correct answer? Ping pong bong. That is fantastic. That Warren Beatty quote is about the night he and Faye Dunaway incorrectly presented the Best Picture Oscar to La La Land.
Oh, yeah, they opened.
You've scored 2 points. The Leading Lights, here's your final very hard question against the clock. Which comedian was nominated for Best Newcomer at the Edinburgh IF Comedy Awards in 2007 with his show Spatula Pad and for Best Show with This Guy at Night 2 years later?
Comedians. Picture clue?
Can we have a picture clue? Picture clue coming up.
Something else. Pussycats. Oh, God.
Can we have an extra fact, please?
Extra fact coming up. He shared a flat in Bristol with Russell Howard, John Robbins and Mark Oliver.
I still wouldn't know.
No idea.
2007.
Different question.
Different question, please.
Different question coming up. In 2015, Lucy Beaumont married which fellow comedian?
No idea.
Oh,
I should know this.
We're going to run out of time.
No.
No idea. No idea.
I can reveal the answer was John Richardson. Oh, okay. That's a picture of 8 cats because Richardson has been a regular captain on the TV show 8 out of 10 cats. That's the end of round three, so let's have a look at those scores. Desperate Daniels are in the lead and have got 22 points, and the Leading Lights have 15 points. Teams, you now have one last chance to win some all-important points. Need I remind you, only the two highest-scoring teams from the entire series will contest the grand final and battle it out for £5,000 and the series champion trophy. Let's play the very hardest question. Now, you will play on the buzzer against each other and only one team can walk away with the points. I will reveal a question. If you think you know the answer, buzz in, answer correctly, and win yourself 8 points. I will continue revealing clues until someone answers the question correctly, but the points on offer will reduce each time a clue is revealed. Answer incorrectly, and your team will be locked out for the remainder of the clues. Fingers on buzzers, please. Here is the very hardest question. Which football club did the Arsenal men's team defeat to begin their run of 49 consecutive top-flight league games unbeaten from May 2003 to October 2004.
I can't guess that.
That was the Invincibles, wasn't it?
8 points going here. Anyone answer?
Yeah, there's no point in wasting.
Your first clue is add words. That traces its roots back to a team founded at a church.
Unless you can think of one straight away.
Can anyone answer for 7 points?
Bear that in mind.
Your next clue is different question. The site of the Roman settlement Clausentum is in which present-day city? Can anyone answer for 6 points?
No, it's got to be Premier League.
Here comes a picture clue. Goodness.
We're going to go for Southampton.
For 5 points, is Southampton the correct answer? Lummis. Wow. Congratulations, Des McDaniels. That is the correct answer and scores you 5 points. So how do you feel about that? I mean, you had a very, very strong end to the evening.
I think with any quiz, if you know the answer to a question, it's an easy question. But if you don't, it's a hard one, isn't it?
Great stuff. And that's it. Here are the final scores. In second place, with a score of 15, we have the Leading Lights. But today's winners, with a score of 27, it is Des McDaniels. Now, you're all competing for a place in the series final where the top two teams will face each other. 27 points sees Des McDaniels just outside the top two spots. 15 points for Leading Lights mean they are down in 10th place, so unfortunately neither team can qualify for the final. Bad luck, you've both been brilliant teams. I hope you've enjoyed yourselves. Thank you for playing. Join me next time when another bunch of very clever people attempt to answer some very hard questions. And finally, I leave you with this very hard question. Why is the time of day with the slowest traffic called rush hour? Goodbye.